baseball from the Big Apple. We're at Yankee Stadium in the Bronx. Ought to be a good one here between the New York Yankees and the Pittsburgh Pirates. Interleague Baseball, next. Stephen Brault, the southpaw out of the Golden State, gets the call here. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
Hey, you don't see a lot of guys that have five pitches, right? Sometimes it's hard to master even two or three, but if you can master five like he has, he'll be in pretty good shape.
And that sends DJ LeMahieu into the box. He will lead this one off today.
Leading off the afternoon for the Yankees, the third baseman.
Ready to deliver. Here comes the first pitch. Strike taken as that one catches the outer part of the plate. In his career against this pitcher, he's 1-for-3.
First pitch, 4 o'clock.
The windup and the 0-1. Oh, and he's really getting the better of him now. It's strike two.
Hey, that was a nasty pitch right there. Ton of rotation on that ball. You could almost see the red dot from up here. Nasty depth.
Swinging a soft liner, and this will be put away easily for the out. Next to hit is Luke Voit. First pitch on its way. A bouncer up the middle, reined in. And there's out number two. Next up is Aaron Judge. First chance for him here in the top of the first with nobody on. And the pitch. Bases are empty here with two men out. Oh, and a good tight slider there, and he's in command, nothing in two.
Hey, boys, you talking about getting your ace swing off right here? That's what it looks like, a guy with mass.
A swing and a miss. That retires the side, and that will do it. 1-2-3 go the Bombers. And now the Pirates will take their turn in a scoreless ball game. Jordan Montgomery, a hurler from South Carolina, will be the starting pitcher in this one. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
Really like this guy. He reminds me a lot of Andy Pettit, left-hander from the University of South Carolina. Not an overpowering fastball, kind of like Andy Pettit. Low to mid-90s fastball, good curveball. His secondary pitches he needs to improve on a little bit, but this guy has a bright future. Quality arm from the left side.
Cole Tucker digging in at the plate. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. And the pitch. Lined hard toward right center. And that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit. Running hard. He's digging for second. He hit the corner and tries for third. And the Pirates have something going to start the inning. He's in there with three bases.
And these fans could not have asked for a better way to start their day. A leadoff triple in the home half, and they're off and running.
Key Brian Hayes digging in now, as he will take strike one on the fastball here. No balls and a strike. Tucker, the runner at third with no outs. Looking to put him away. Here's the 0-2. Still no balls and two strikes.
He's certainly pushing the throttle and pulling it with those four pitches. Statistics class tells me I'm sitting fast.
Voit is over, and he's got it for the first out of the inning.
Batting third, the center fielder, Ryan Reynolds.
So one gone with the runner at third, and that'll bring up Brian Reynolds. From the stretch.
Hey, love the confidence in that pitch right there, going right after one of the better hitters on this team, not afraid to execute.
Oh, one pitch on its way. This is line to left. And that'll get down out there. And they're going to take a 1-0 lead as the run comes across to score.
Boy, he had to be sitting on a fastball, D-Row, right there, because he pulls this one and gets the barrel to it to drive that runner in from third.
Yeah, Dan, you could tell he was sitting all over it. You don't get to a fastball like that without knowing it's coming. Nice piece of hit.
In now, Colin Moran, as he'll take a look at a high strike that time. It's nothing and one. First shot for him here with a runner at first now and one away. Fastball called for strike two. Time to check our umpires in this one. Behind the plate is Freddie Ferguson.
Hey, D-Row, you better be ready to swing, particularly at that low pitch. Freddie Ferguson, low ball umpire.
Yeah, makes it tough on the offense. I was a guy who liked the low ball, but that usually means those guys are susceptible to that slider in the dirt. You have to see the ball up, and this guy doesn't give you a chance.
Fouled off. The 0-2 once more.
Nope, that's a ball.
Runners on first with one down. And he fouls this one off. And another foul ball. And a good take there. Close, but it's 2-2.
Wow, this is an unbelievable at bat. I mean, talk about a battle. This is it. Love it.
Fouled away. He's set. Here's the 2-2. And he finally wins the battle as this is swung on and missed for the second out.
One thing to know is not all strikeouts are created equal. Right there, he goes down on strikes, but he really made that guy on the mound work for it. And when you're doing that in the first inning, it can have an effect on how deep he's going to be able to go into this start. There's a big difference between that and going down on three or four pitches.
Jacob Stallings will be the next hitter. He takes his first cuts in this one with a man at first and two away. Now the 0-1.
Ooh, that's a good pitch to take a hack at right there. Change up up in the zone. He'd like to have that one back.
Two out with the man at first. A bouncer to the left side. Scooped up. Throw on to Voit, takes care of him, and the inning is over. One in the inning for the Pirates on a couple of hits. Leading off the inning, it'll be Giancarlo Stanton, and they could use a spark from him here.
Giancarlo Stanton.
Now the first pitch. The fastball here is he'll take a look at ball one, 1-0. Can't get around quick enough, and that'll move the count to 1-1.
It's going to be back to some serious T work if he can't put that pitch in play right in his wheelhouse.
Fouled off again, and now he's in a 1-2 hole. Into the windup and the pitch. Now a foul tip right into the catcher's glove as he's able to hang on for the first out.
One of the big advantages to pitching ahead in the count if you're a pitcher, because you have to cover both pitches if you're a hitter. You have to cover the off speed and the fastball. And in a 1-2 count, you might be sitting off speed. And what happens? He gets the fastball and he can't catch up to the express.
Into the box, Aaron Hicks. Swing and a ball hit softly on the ground. And that's the second out. So the bases are empty with two gone now. And that'll bring up the exciting middle infielder, Gleyber Torres. Ready to deal. Here comes the first pitch. Grounded back up the middle. He's got it. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as this side is retired. So the Yanks go 1-2-3. They trail this one 1-0. Bottom of the inning now, and up next will be Yoshi Tsutsugo.
For the Pirates, the right fielder, Yoshi Tsutsugo.
And now the first pitch. And it's fouled away. Tsutsugo, a 6'1" left-handed hitter, but throws right-handed. He's a second-year big leaguer. The windup and the 0-1. Fly ball out toward left center field. Therefore, it is Stanton, and he's got it for the first out.
Batting seven, the left fielder, Ben Gamble.
And that'll bring up Ben Gamble. First pitch on its way. Lazy fly ball out to center field. Torres ranging into the outfield. He gets there and makes a fine running play for the second out.
Boy, he showed some pretty good range heading pretty deep into the outfield to bring that one down. Thought the outfielder might call him off, but he clearly had it under control.
Standing in now, Kevin Newman. As he'll pop this one foul off to the left and out of play. He'll try to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second. The pitch. Now a swing and he gets him to pop it up. Judge is on his horse. And this is going to wind up a foul ball. Into the windup. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. Fouled off.
Hey, have an AB right here. I know it's frustrating the heck out of the pitcher. You keep fouling these pitches off, maybe one misses over the heart of the plate.
Another foul ball, and this battle will continue. The next 0-2. It's the top of the zone. He struck him out looking. 1-2-3 go the Pirates. We play two innings. It's 1-0. Now into the box, Gary Sanchez. He's the number 7 hitter, but he's leading off the third after the first 6 guys in the lineup have been retired in order.
Yeah, it's been a great start to the guy on the mound. It'll be interesting to see if they can find a way to get to this guy before he really settles in.
Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch.
The offense better get it going right here, because they certainly can tell from their dugout this guy is carrying himself with a presence out on the mound. He's got feel for all his pitches.
2-0 now. Hard liner to center field. That's a hit, the first of the game for the Yankees.
Batting it, the shortstop, Gio Urshela.
That'll bring in Giovanni Urshela. This is foul right side. Comes set with the 0-1. Changeup gets him out in front for strike two.
Wow, what makes it so tough to be a hitter is to be able to hit and change his speeds, right? You're geared up for the fastball, and all of a sudden, he pulls the string and throws you the straight change, the dreaded equalizer.
Little tardy on that swing as it's well wide of first. Now another 0-2. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Here comes the right fielder. He gets to it and makes the catch for the first out. So now here is Jordan Montgomery. He could be bunting here in order to stay out of the double play. First delivery to him. And he swings through a fastball and doesn't catch up with it. It's 0-1.
Hey, either this hitter needs a cup of coffee or he was sitting off speed right there.
A swinging strike, and now it's 0-2.
Hey, you know in the back of your mind as a batter right here, he's got that nasty sinker. I know it's 0-2, but he might not be looking for the punch out. You have to find a way as a batter to get that two-seamer up in the zone, or you're going to ground into a double play.
So he racks up the swinging strikeout on the breaking ball. Jordan Montgomery is out number two here in the third inning. He's set, and the pitch. DJ LeMahieu is at the plate now, and he takes a called strike.
That elevated fastball right there, that is the biggest change in the game today for me. When I first came up, a lot of guys working that Greg Maddux east to west.
Behind 0-2 now. Nothing in two count, and the pitch. Waved at and missed for the third out. Not much of a chance at hitting that one, and the inning is over. One left for the Yankees. It remains 1-0. So here is Stephen Brault as we move on to the bottom of inning number three.
Stephen Brault.
First pitch on the way. And a ball 1-0. And he fouls this one off. The 1-1. This pitch is popped up and no one can get there. It's a foul ball. Still a ball and two strikes. Here he comes again, 1-2.
I don't blame the pitcher one bit for trying to get to Chase right there. He's been fouling everything off. He's still got the entire arsenal open to him. So we'll see what pitch he comes with next.
And that'll get down for a base hit. And this one will bounce into the wall. And it's a good start to the inning for the Bucks. It's a leadoff double.
When you've got the pitcher leading off an inning, you have to feel pretty confident about getting the first out without much problems. But the pitcher with a bat in his hands had other ideas. Put some solid wood on it and found himself on second with the leadoff double.
Into the box now, Cole Tucker. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Hicks on the move. He makes the catch, and the runner from second will tag and head for third. The relay throw, and he'll get into third here on the flyout, so he's 90 feet away here with one gone.
He
rookie Brian Hayes comes on with one gone here as he looks at a called strike one.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
The 0-1 delivery. Swing and a line drive. That gets down. He's got himself a base hit. And not in time as the run scores.
Last pitch was a fastball, tries to double up with the same piece of cheese, and it gets turned around. Nice piece of hit.
So now it's Brian Reynolds. Timing just a tick off there as this one's fouled off to the right. Called strike two with the letters. 0-2 now.
I know he's been struggling early, but that pitch right there, well-executed changeup. If he can mix that in, maybe he hangs around for a little while longer.
Throw won't get him.
Well, you know what? Good hitters are good hitters for a reason, D-Row. And to be able to hang in there on an 0-2 pitch and still be able to get a base hit, this guy's about as good as it gets.
Yeah, I'm blown away by this guy, Dan. You wouldn't know if you showed up. You wouldn't know if it's 2-0.
And he'll make it in to score. It's a sack fly and an RBI, and it's now a 3-0 ball game. First offering on its way. And look out as that fastball ran in and got him. Ouch, bang.
Well, the pitcher can claim that that one slipped all he wants, but that looked intentional to me. He goes with the heater up and in and absolutely drills him. That's dangerous, and I'm surprised that the ump appears to be letting it go.
Flew out in his only at-bat so far. And he fires in a strike this time to make it one ball and one strike. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
A lot of pitches away here, which is pretty much what you're forced to do with lefty batters here at Yankee Stadium. It doesn't take much to hook one out of here to right field with that short porch out there.
Fouled away. Here's another 2-2. Hit on the ground to third. Throw to first in time, and the big inning is avoided as the side is retired. So two runs on three hits, no errors, and a couple of men left. Three innings complete. It's the Pirates 3 and the Yankees nothing. Stepping up is Luke Voit, 0-for-1 for him here in this one.
Hey, Matty, they need to get some offense going in this one. Getting a run back in this inning, give them a little bit of confidence that they can keep up in this game.
Now the first pitch. In there, strike one. Hit sharply on the ground. Oh, look at the sliding stop. It's there. He got him. And what a vital play there, preventing the leadoff man from getting aboard.
Wow, what a great show of range there. This ball looked like it might get through up the middle, but check out the sliding stop, and that's going to take him right into a good throwing position where he's able to get enough on the throw to get him out at first.
Here's Big Aaron Judge. Little chopper back to the mound. On to first, and that is two quick outs to start the fourth. Stepping in next, Giancarlo Stanton struck out in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
Swung on and missed for the first strike.
I'd like to see this lineup start working the count a little bit more and drive up this pitcher's pitch count.
The 0-1 is a fastball low, and that evens the count at 1-1. No runs, just one hit, and no errors for the Yankees so far. Swing and a miss as he pulled the string on him, 1-2.
Hey, make no mistake about it. This lineup's going to have to get going and get a little bit more aggressive. This guy's pounding the zone.
And it's fouled away. Again, a 1-2. Swung on in the dirt for the third strike. And that ends the inning. So they breeze through this half of the inning. To the bottom of inning number four we go. It's the Pirates 3 and the Yankees nothing. Welcome back to the Bronx as we check in with Heidi.
Matt, I had a chance to catch up with manager Derek Shelton during the commercial break about the Pirates' offense, and he was very pleased with how little they're swinging and missing right now. Our research team found that to this point in the game, they've only missed the ball on less than 5% of their swings. Major League average is closer to 25%. So to put it simply, their hand-eye coordination at the plate is second to none right now.
Good stuff, Heidi. Thanks. Now to the plate, here is Ben Gamel. He flew out in his last AB.
Ben Gamel.
First offering on its way. A ball and no strikes. Tries to go the other way as this is in the air to left field. Stanton comes in a few steps as he hauls it in for the first out.
Now batting.
Digging in will be Kevin Newman. He went down looking in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, Matty, and he was locked up by a good fastball for strike three last.
Here comes the Yankee manager now up out of the dugout on his way to the mound. And he's going to motion for the bullpen as that'll be all for his starter this afternoon. So he will curiously make his way to the dugout after what has to be considered a very brief appearance. Luis Severino answers the call from the pen here in the fourth as they didn't get the outing they were hoping for from their starter. Three runs, five hits, and no errors so far for the Pirates. Now a ball lined hard toward right center. And that'll split the gap as it should be extra bases. And he'll reach second now with one away.
As a hitter, the only feeling better than hitting a bomb is driving one into the gap like that. He hustled out of the box knowing he was guaranteed a double, but I think he had thoughts of maybe a triple if the outfielder hadn't gotten it back in right away.
Yeah, there really wasn't any question about that one going for extra bases off the bat. Pirates pitcher at the plate with a 1-2 count. Fouled off.
We're going to see him throw that hard fastball early and often.
Ground ball sent back up the middle. And that's through into center field. Base hit. And he's going to score with ease as the throw will be too late.
The batter, number three.
Stepping in now, Cole Tucker. And he fouls this one off. One for two in the ball game thus far. Ready with the nothing and one pitch. Goes the other way, and this is in the air out to left. Under it now is Stanton to make the catch, and there are two away now. Two down with a runner at first, and up next is Key Brian Hayes. Starts him out with a fastball too low for ball one. Now a swing, Owen. Look out! Over in the third base dugout as that thing nearly took out half the coaching staff.
Well, you know he didn't get cheated right there. He swung so hard he lost the bat. Gotta believe he's gonna get some jabs and take some heat when he gets back to the dugout.
Two balls and a strike. Now a ball lined toward the gap in left center. And that ball gets down out near the wall and should be extra bases. Brault rounds the corner and is headed home. He will score as they extend the lead to 5-0.
And that just pains a pitcher. They already given up a run in the inning, and he has two outs, almost out of trouble, but then serves up a mistake. The runner busted around the bases to score from first, and the hitter is in scoring position on second.
Hit in the air to shallow center. Hicks is under it. And he makes the play to end the inning. So it's two runs on three hits, no errors, and a runner left on. We played four full. Bucks out in front, 5-0. Welcome back. Heidi Watney standing by as we get set for the top of the fifth.
Thanks, Matt. I talked with Yankees manager Aaron Boone during the break about the team's offensive performance so far, and he told me, overall, he's not happy with the at-bats they're putting together. They've only managed one base runner in this game, so it's easy to see why he said they haven't shown much fight today. He's hoping to see someone step up and find a way to get something going, though. This game isn't out of hand, so it remains to be seen if they can snap out of this funk and climb back into this one.
Okay, thank you, Heidi.
The center fielder, Aaron Hicks.
Now here's the first offering. Aaron Hicks will stand in for a second time here as he swings and misses there. It's nothing and one.
Hey, it's a game of execution. If the pitcher stays right there, this lineup's going to continue to have a tough time.
Skied in the air to straightaway left. Gamble has him played perfectly as he puts it away for out number one.
Up next for the Yankees.
Now one down with the bases empty. And that'll bring up Gleyber Torres. Big swing, but he just gets a piece of it. Strike one. One out, nobody on. Lined to short, but gobbled up there, and there are two away. Base is empty, two away, and that'll bring up Gary Sanchez. Swing and a miss, and he's behind 0-1.
Yeah, I'm not sure what the game plan is today. Too many early swings. They got to be a little bit more patient at the plate.
Hit the other way out toward right field. Tsutsugo will get there, and he puts it away to retire the side. 1-2-3 go the Bombers. Need to get it going soon. It's 5-0. Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and next to bat will be the first baseman, Colin Moran.
The first baseman, Colin Moran.
Here's the pitch. Hit back up the middle. Reined in. And there's one down now. So next to bat will be Jacob Stallings. Comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. Fly ball right down the line in left. Stanton has a read on it. Two gone. First offering.
Yoshi
Tsutsugo is in with two away now as he looks at a called strike one.
He'll take that first pitch strike all day long. If they're going to take 0-0, he's going to pound that zone and get ahead. Much more susceptible down 0-1 than 1-0.
Got him swinging as he runs the fastball by him to end the inning. Down in order go the Pirates, but they hold a 5-0 lead. And now in the box, Gio Urshela will start things out in their half of the sixth as they look to shake things up here for a lineup that, quite frankly, has been non-existent to date.
Yeah, I think if I'm the hitting coach right here, Matty, I'm telling the offense to get aggressive. Just seems like we've been going too deep in counts, and this guy has got exploding stuff on the mound. So I would tell them get overly aggressive on a heater in the middle of the plate early.
A ball and a strike.
Hey, it's tough when your team is being held scoreless on the scoreboard. He was trying to put him on the board with a swing like that one.
Tried to crush that ball and now perhaps needs to shorten up with two strikes. Had to wait back on the changeup, and he did a good job just to make contact. Now another 1-2. And a good sinker there gets him swinging for the first out. Didn't look to me like that was much of a protect swing with two strikes.
No, he was trying to go yard, two strikes or not. Kind of looks bad if you strike out like he did, though. I'm sure his manager would have liked for him to focus on getting on base.
Strike one to start the at bat. The windup and the 0-1. Oh, and he's really getting the better of him now. It's strike two.
Hey, watch out. This hitter's got one thing on his mind.
Swing and a miss on the fastball that time. Out number two.
he's just ringing up strikeouts left and right. But what's really impressive to me, he hasn't walked anyone either. He's just pounding the zone. His stuff is dirty today.
DJ LeMahieu is in for the third time as he swings and misses at that one. It's nothing and one.
Hey, the guy on the mound is absolutely pounding his zone, and that's why he's been able to stay and pitch deep into this game.
Fouled away. Into the windup. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. Grounded to short. Newman fields it cleanly. Throw on to first gets him, and the side is retired. So the Yanks go 1-2-3. They can't chip into that 5-0 deficit. Jonathan Loaisiga enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth. And
here we go. For the Pirates, the left fielder, Ben Gamble.
First pitch coming. Here it is. Didn't quite catch the zone there. Ball one. Pulled toward right center field. Hicks is under it. One away. Up next for the Buccos, Kevin Newman. He came across to score after doubling in his last at bat. Ready to deal. Here comes the first pitch. 0-1. Here it comes. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball. Bases are empty, one man out. And he gets him to pop it up on the right side of the infield. And he'll put this away for the second out. Next, it'll be Stephen Brault getting to hit for himself here, largely due to the big cushion he's got to work with. One ball, no strikes to count. Now a fastball for a called strike. It's 1-1. Two out, nobody on. And it's 1-2. Got him swinging, and that will end the inning. 1-2-3 go the Pirates as they're unable to add to their 5-0 lead. It ain't no surprise. A full moon sits in the sky. New inning set to get underway, and stepping in the long ball threat, Luke Voit. Here's the first pitch. And he just keeps rolling along as he starts another batter out with strike one.
This guy's throwing a gem so far. Biggest key, 80% of his first pitches have been for strikes.
Behind 0-2 now. Nothing in two count, and the pitch.
Wow, this guy has been on top of it today, pushing the throttle and pulling it when he needs to.
And he struck him out. Strikeout number 8 now in the ballgame for him. So now into the box is Aaron Judge. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. Swing and a miss that time. It's 0-1.
That was a great hack right there. Timing was on point. Just sometimes you have bad bat barrel accuracy.
Hit in the air down the right field line, and that will end up a foul ball. And he punches out another one, make it 9 for the ball game. Giancarlo Stanton now trying to avoid becoming the third strikeout victim of the inning here. And he's way off balance with the swing there. Swinging strike, and now it's 0-2.
So far, this has been a terrific outing for this guy. Throwing well, keeping his pitches to a minimum, locating his fastball.
We'll leave it right there as he strikes out, and that ends the inning. 1-2-3 go the Bombers. Need to get it going soon. It's 5-0. Last half of the seventh here, and that'll bring in the second baseman, Cole Tucker.
The second baseman, Cole Tucker.
And now the first pitch.
Nope. Ball one.
Well behind that fastball. It's a swinging strike.
That's not really where you want to miss right there. I know this guy has got power stuff, but you can't live in the middle of the plate against this lineup and expect to have success.
So we got him looking there. Cole Tucker is retired for the first out in the bottom half of the seventh inning. Key Brian Hayes stands in as he can't connect here. 0-1. So he'll add one to his total as that falls in. He's got three hits in this one.
Hey, this guy's obviously seeing the ball right now. That's another hard hit single. 3 for 4 right there. He's looking super solid at the plate.
Brian Reynolds comes on with one away as he looks at a ball. It's 1-0. So far, 2 for 3 in this one. Fastball called strike. 1-2.
You know, most people would be surprised he took that right there because that looked like it was in his honey hole. He had to obviously be sitting on something else.
Grounded down the third baseline. LeMahieu's got it on to first, and there were two down.
Now, Pat.
Next will be the cleanup hitter, Colin Moran. 0-for-2 on the afternoon so far. No balls and a strike to count. 0-1 pitch on its way. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Taking it in there is Hicks for the final out of the inning. Pirates leave one, so they hold a 5-0 lead. Digging in, the switch hitter, Aaron Hicks. We're in the eighth now, and nothing's changed out there on the mound.
Nah, they just haven't had much of an answer, Matty. They've been off balance and baffled all game. He's got a nice, comfortable lead. You have to think he's going to pound the strike zone. But here, get aggressive.
Ready to deliver. Here comes the first pitch. Hit hard back up the middle and into center field. A base hit. So early trouble here to start the eighth inning.
You take a look at the numbers up to this point. You see he's only given up two hits so far today. So he's been hitting his spots all game long. Remains to be seen if he can keep that shutout intact going forward. But I'm not betting against him.
Gleyber Torres is at the plate now, and he's quickly behind 0-1. Hard hit ball to second, and that finds its way through for a base hit. And that runner will hold up at second with two aboard now. Next to dig in, Gary Sanchez. And his guys are looking to erase that donut on the scoreboard with a runner in scoring position.
Yeah, Matt, they've been really shut down so far in this one. They've had runners on base, but haven't been able to string anything together.
Tsutsugo is there to put it away for out number one. Next up, Gio Urshela. He was sat down on strikes in his last at-bat. First pitch on its way. Hit on the ground toward the left. To second for one. On to first, it's a double play. As their woes continue, the inning is over. The Yanks leave one. They can't chip into that 5-0 deficit. I'm too involved in God, not television. Bottom of inning number eight set to go. And now it'll be the catcher, Jacob Stallings.
The catcher, Jacob Stallings.
first delivery to him. And a called strike down in the zone, nothing and one. And it's fouled away. He's ready. Here's the 0-2 pitch. Swing and a little blooper to center. Coming on for it is Hicks. He can't get to it. This one's down.
The right fielder, number 32, Yoshi Tsutsugo.
The batter will be Yoshitomo Tsutsugo as he takes a called strike at the knees. It's 0-1. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. Fouled off. Set to deliver on nothing and two. Here it comes. Not a bad pitch there with two strikes, but it misses 1-2.
Man, that's a good take there on that 0-2 fastball just missed. He must have a really good eye at the plate.
Popped up. Torres has it, and there's one away.
Now batting.
He's set. Here it comes. He's running. Just gets a piece of it. Strike one. Lifted down the line and left. But this is going to wind up a foul ball. The 0-2 delivery. And a fastball blew it right by him, and there are two down. Didn't mess around much in that at bat, Dan.
No, that was pretty impressive, Matt. I really like a pitcher that trusts and works off his fastball. Right there, he decided he didn't need to use anything else. Three straight heaters and go grab some bench.
Behind 0-2 now. Stallings is off of first with two away. And strike three called as he says, you got to be kidding me, with the side retired. One left for Pittsburgh as they're unable to add to their 5-0 lead. Joey Gallo is going to pinch hit here to lead off the ninth, and with his club already well down, he'll just need to try and get on base here. Ready to deliver. Here comes the first pitch. And we kick off the ninth inning with a swinging strike here. Nothing and one. A bouncer to the left side. And the leadoff man in the inning will get the job done here. It's an infield single.
Hey, I can only take you inside the mind of the batter right here. Had a lot of swinging bunts in my day. Soon as that ball hits the dirt in front of you, you are getting it down to first base.
Oh, look at this. To second for one. On to first, a double play. Now to bat, Luke Voit. He's their last shot here with two away in the ninth as they look to avoid the shutout.
Yeah, Matt, they just haven't had any answer for the great pitching so far in this one.
0-1 the count. Now here's the pitch. High chopper to third. Fielded cleanly. Throw to first will be in time for the final out, and the Pirates get a complete game shutout from their starter as this ball game is over. 5-0 the final score today. The Pittsburgh Pirates jumped out to an early lead in the first and never looked back. Stephen Brault earns the victory on the mound. Jordan Montgomery couldn't escape the fourth inning as he slapped with the loss. So that will wrap things up. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our whole crew, I'm Matt Vaskirjan. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, head to theshow.com. Clear the base. Pick up the pace. I'm about to chase. Money in case. Clear the base.
gotta call for it if you got it. Going live, good, it is so big of the face. Two seam ain't enough. Four tie team is us. Man, on first, on second, on third. I'ma have to clean it up. I done went yard, they ball gone. The alien beamed it up. That contract, they want me back. I'ma have to green it up like Fenway Wall. Really feel fine. Worry about y'all, it's just my time. I got my swing right, that's a green.